Hi and welcome to this video. In this video, let's see how you can reset your server on Vultr. If you have a server that you have deployed on Vultr and you want to reset it, then this is how you can do it. So first things first, if the server is using an SSH key, I'm going to show you how to reset it. But if you're just using a password, you can just come in here and click on server reinstall, and that's going to reinstall the server and you can log back in. But if you're using an SSH key, you have to click on the server, then come into settings, and then under reinstall SSH, this is going to wipe all the data on the server while setting up the SSH key. So choose the SSH key that you want to work with for that server here. You can set up your SSH keys under your account. If you go to account, you're going to see SSH keys and you can add an SSH key. So I want to use this key. So I'm just going to click on reinstall, and you can see it's going to reset the server. All the data will be lost. It will be like starting afresh with a brand new Vultr server. So I'm going to say yes, change the SSH keys on this server, and then reinstall the SSH keys. So let's wait for it to finish up, and then we're going to see how to log into the server. There you go. The server is now running. Let's see if we can log into the server. Enter. I had already logged into the server, so I can remove this from my known hosts just by running this line. Copy, paste, enter. I'll do Control L to clear the screen. Run this again. Oh, not that, but this one. To log into the server. Confirm, yes, enter. And now we're logged into our server. Just in case you're wondering which server is this and how can I log in, how can I set up the SSH keys? This is a server that I showed you how to deploy in the last video. In the last video, just a recap, what we did is I showed you how to generate an SSH key on your computer, add it to Vultr, use that key to deploy a new Ubuntu server, and then showed you how to log into your Ubuntu server using the SSH key. So if that's something you don't know how to do, just watch the previous video. I'm going to add the link in the description. If I don't, just remind me. All right, that's pretty much covers how to reset or reinstall your Vultr server.